Channel. It's been a little bit since we've been on here. It's been like over a year.
Yeah, it's been a long time.
A lot's happened in the last year. We actually started a company.
We did.
It's called Clash Collective, and the slogan is "Where Automotive Worlds Collide." Do you want to tell them a little bit about our company?
Yeah. So basically, it was our plan to make something that, long story short, it was. A mix of off-road, street, show, drift, kind of a little bit of everything in the whole automotive world. And that's where we came up with Clash, because it's like off-road and street are clashing to make one. And yeah, we've got a little bit of everything as far as cars that cover every spectrum of the off-road and street world. So that was where it started. But
we also got a new puppy. Her name is Holly. I'll get her.
Yeah, so we did get a puppy. And also, we've got a lot of projects that we've been working on, and new projects, some old projects. If you've been with us for a long time, you probably would remember half the stuff we've been working on. Some of it's done, some of it we're still working on.
Hey, Holly.
Good evening.
Oh, what a good girl. Hi.
All right, so today's project, we're going to be building a NRG seat into an office chair. So we're going to fabricate some type of stand underneath. I thought about getting a little bit crazy and like making this like post that comes over here and holds the TV in front of me for gaming, but I don't know, we might not get that crazy. So we're gonna start fabricating the stand, and let's see where this ends up.
So we've been tossing around a few ideas of what to do with the seat in order to make it comfortable and pivot and kind of act like an office chair. We don't have any kind of normal office chair that has like the shock that goes up and down and pivots and rocks and whatnot. So I've got these old coilovers, or springs from my coilovers off the Off-Road 240, and we're going to try to weld it together on the base somehow, to where, if you remember, like at the playgrounds, there's little kid things that you can like rock on and spring on the base. We're going to try to use one of these and see if it's stiff enough to function. So we're going to try a couple ways to kind of mock it up first off the chair and just see how much it flexes. And then if it works, find a way to mount it to the seat. Trust it, like I'm just gonna weld it, because I don't know if I trust it tacked, because it's kind of gnarly. It's a lot of weight with like side to side leverage. Oh, I think it might work. So basically what we did is I just set this on, tacked it in place so that the frame that bolts to the actual brackets are square. I'm gonna pull it off, weld it, and then these guys will come down to the base that actually sits on the ground. So, do that.
All right, so obviously we still have to build the legs, but Jake just wanted to test to see how much it would move
around. I knew
around.
It was gonna be too, it was gonna bend too much, like the spring's not stiff enough, but I didn't realize it was gonna be this bad. Like it's, it'll basically fall, like you could fall out of it. It might be like more of a balancing act than a comfortable seat.
So I know it wobbles around too much, but what do you think if we use like limit straps after we build the frame?
It might work. I mean, if we put a strap on each side to where when you lean this way, it would hit and hold it from moving too far. That might be possible.
Do you have some?
No.
That's my fender.
You already knocked it down for a TikTok video. I think we're good. All right, so what we're doing now is we're going to be building a square base to sit on the ground that we're going to weld tubes up to the bottom of the spring plate. So we're going to do 290s on one tube. We're going to mirror that, and then we're going to weld the two ends together to make one big circle. And we're going for about 30 inches in diameter, so we're going to go 10 inches from when the bend starts because it's a 5-inch radius. If we do it right, it should be about 30 when we're done. So let's get to bending. So bending it didn't really work. We have a scrap tube over there. It didn't go so well. So what we did is just did four individual pieces that are exactly the same, a little bit easier. Just gonna meet them all up like this and then weld each section. All right, so now that we have the base done, we're gonna get our tubes that are gonna go from the base to our lower spring plate. And that will support everything and hold it all together. It's way too springy. Ready? Boing.
All right, so this is what my welds looked like after. So the video cut off, but that's the final product of my welds. So Jake finished welding the rest of the frame. We're gonna put the seat on and test it. It's gonna be pretty, it's durable, but it's flimsy. Does that make sense?
It's gonna be ridiculously wobbly. It's gonna
yeah,
be.
Wobbly.
That's fucking insane. That is.
Okay, hold on. Let me sit in it.
Oh my god.
Was that you, babe, or was
that? That was a terrifying sound, whatever that was.
Oh my god. Okay.
Do you want to try to actually balance?
Yeah. Hold on.
All right, guys, ready? On the count of three.
Balancing?
This is horrible.
No.
What?
We just need to modify it.
Two, three.
I have my
chair. All right, so the chair was ready for paint, but last week it rained all week, so we weren't able to paint because our garage is filled with car parts and a car. So meanwhile, I was sitting in the chair a lot and I was rocking back and forth, and there was too much stress on the spring, so the spring actually snapped. So this is what it looks like now. There's where it snapped. This was just like a temporary way to help stiffen the spring, and then other part of the spring is right there. So we're gonna have to figure something else out other than this spring. It was kind of a long shot in the first place. So we're gonna brainstorm some ideas and get back to it.
All right, so what we decided to do was go with the original idea, but we went and got a bigger spring because this spring that we had was too soft, so it was way too wobbly. So what we ended up doing is my friend Ryan, which you guys have seen if you follow our videos with the green truck, he let us have this off of his new F-150 because we put a lift kit on it. This is a much heavier duty spring, bigger coil, bigger gauge, so it's gonna be a lot stiffer. Now what I did is just made a couple little like pillars out of solid steel to basically support the back half of the spring. That way it's sturdy all the way around. I'm gonna weld that in, fully weld it all the way around. And then I have a few cut out I'm gonna do for the same thing for the top. So there'll be a post here, 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 and then a long one over here that will tie into this little bit. So that way it's supported all the way around here. And then we'll have this whole middle section for flexibility. So hopefully this time it'll work out. It's gonna work.
It's all dry. This is what it looks like now. I like the purple spring. I think it makes really good contrast and it matches the seat really well. So I'm gonna go ahead and put the seat on the sand and then we're gonna be able to sit on it. And hopefully the spring won't break this time.
So we just finished up the seat. Darcy is testing it out. It is painted and it is rocking.
It's like the perfect amount. The other one was a lot more fun because you could like really rock in it, but this is like acceptable.
This is what we call practical. There you go. Yeah, and this big old giant spring I don't think is gonna break. And I welded in some extra supports here and here and down there. So that way the rings are supported all the way around, except for in the center. But basically, that's it.
So that's a wrap for the video today. Thank you so much, NRG, for sponsoring this seat. We're really happy with how the stand came out. And I do have to say, when I was rocking in it and the other spring broke, like literally I didn't feel anything. I just like opened my eyes and I was looking at the ceiling.
She straight fell on her back. It was hilarious.
The seat honestly kept me so secure and I was like really impressed. So thank you, NRG, and we will see you guys on the next one.